Hello, my people. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for the messages and the solidarity. I watched with tears in my eyes as Nigerians came out yesterday, you know, to speak up in protest on the streets, on social media, on TV, on radio, and so on. You know, I watched as Nigerians demonstrated that no one voice is louder than the other, whether you be Tubaba or you be security forces or you be anybody, you know. I watched as many people call me a coward, but I'm happy that I'm a coward that spoke up, and I will always continue to speak up. You know, I watched as many of you defied all odds to come out to tell the government, to demand from the government that you deserve better lives. You understand what I'm saying? I'm grateful for everybody that, you know, lent their voice when I lost mine. You know, you guys are the real heroes. I'm happy you came out yesterday, and I'm happy you came out peacefully.
John Osage, another day, and I had a verse for Two-Face, man. Two-Face had a chance to make history in the world. He had a chance to make all his fans around the world proud. How can you call for a protest that you cannot face the challenges? Man, you fall my hand, man. It's a big shame to all these so-called Nigerian celebrities who call themselves celebrities, but have never spoken for change in Nigeria. You call yourself celebrity, you cannot use your voice to make an impact. So many of your fans around the world are affected by the hardship of Nigeria. You have fans in Italy who are doing prostitution because of hardship in Nigeria. You have fans that go across the Mediterranean Sea that die every day, but you have not said anything about it. We have electricity issue. Because you can afford a gen, you don't say anything about it. We have bad roads, but you don't say anything about it. We have health care. There's a baby I'm currently working with that has a heart problem, but cannot get health care in this country. You have not said anything about it. And you call yourself a celebrity. You go about wearing fake China clothes. You call yourself a celebrity with your fake bling. I don't know how you all call it. It's a big shame on Two-Face. And Two-Face, all the respect I have for you as a man is no longer. And to all the other celebrities, they call themselves, I don't even want to mention it, Casey, Harrison, Wizkid, one says it's a Bado or whatever, Olamide. Not a shame. I am not a celebrity, but every day I use myself as the example of the change I want to see. I'm not a politician, but every day he hurts me after traveling around the world to see my people living so impoverished. That is the purpose of being a celebrity. Be a celebrity of a good cause. Today we are supposed to march. I personally printed 100 t-shirts to support the Two-Face movement. Coming out there telling us that, oh, due to psychosis, which kind of man you be? Useless man.
To his primary responsibility, that he has a responsibility to do the greatest good for the greatest number of people within the shortest possible time. It is almost 2 years now. And we are still rigmaroling within the periphery of the microcosm. Let me quote the Archbishop B.A. Idahosa. He says, if you have a desire, do not retire, but refire to acquire your desire. We have a desire and we have converged here today. And we will not retire, but instead we will refire. If it doesn't happen today, it will happen next week. If it doesn't happen next week, it will happen next month. If it doesn't happen next month, it will happen next year. If Two-Face pulls out today, One-Face will join in today. There are very many people who are dissatisfied, who are disenchanted. Even those police officers who are there, don't buy from a different market. The market of 40 cents, demand and supply also affects them. So even though they are wearing uniform, they are wearing black uniform. Outside, indeed, they are wearing green cloth on the outside. If you look properly, you will see that they are part of us. Their faces are forlorn, and they are supporting us in what we are doing. Borrowing the language of Otuku as I end, he said, the death of every Nigerian affects me. And because I'm a Nigerian, I'm involved. I travel all the way from Edo State, cross several cities, cross several oceans and bridges to be here today. And I'm happy that I'm here. And I'm happy that these men are here. So when I go back, I can report to say I came, I saw, and I go back.
Police commissioner are there with us. They provide security for us. Oh, yeah, what? Oh, yeah, what? They must hear what? They must hear what? You know they carry everybody's first man along. They must hear what.
Hello, my fellow Nigerians. Since the idea of a nationwide march was first mentioned, the need for urgent solutions to the challenges facing Nigerians has become very clear. The people have hoped for a better Nigeria since 1990, even way before 1999, you know, but things are not getting any better for the majority. We are still where we are, poor and desperate. I would not long by it. I want to thank EIE, the Two Face Foundation, numerous colleagues and countless fellow Nigerians for stepping up to partner with me. I'm just a musician with the point of view and the ear of my fans. I have dedicated my time and resources to peace building, voter education towards peaceful elections, and youth engagement in governance in Nigeria. This time around, my partners, colleagues, and I have come together to present a platform for Nigerians to communicate their real pains to government at all levels in a peaceful and articulate manner with a view to getting lasting solutions to our problems. This march is about demanding that our leaders connect with all the people of Nigeria. This march is about demanding that all saboteurs of good government policies should hands off. This march is about encouraging positive-minded Nigerians, serious, hardworking, genuine, patriotic Nigerians to continue to work without intention. The problem of Nigeria is way beyond one person. It's way beyond just the president. The problem of Nigeria is just a handful of people that don't want things to go. You understand? We have to say that it's clear that not the majority. Okay, now, what is this match not about? It is not a platform for politicians of any party to manipulate. I know you will still spin it, but for 1 second, leave your battles aside. And just not trying to score cheap political points against one, you know. It is not a point scoring exercise. It's certainly not personal. It is not an organized battle. With all respect to our comrades who have done much for Nigeria, this march is for the unrepresented. You know, it is not a my religion or tribe is better than my tribe is better than yours matter. All our blood is red, all of us they bleed. All of us, they feel the pain. You understand? You know, so I, Innocent Dibia, I am a living example of a Nigerian who owes their success to Nigerians of every tribe and religion. No one asked what religion or tribe I was before supporting me. You know, and I'm better. You understand? So therefore, it is with every sense of humility, I say, with this march, we want to demand for security. All Nigerians matter. Religion, ethnicity, part of the country, legally determine the type of protection I get from my government. According to the Constitution, security and welfare of the people should be the primary purpose of government. Education. Let's develop beyond oil. We have to invest in our human capital. Every child must have access to quality education. If our teachers are not paid, how will we raise the next generation to lead the country and run our business? Health. Health is wealth. But people die daily from lack of basic, affordable health care. We can definitely do better. You know, power. Government needs to make it easier to generate power at the state and local government level so that everything is not tied to the center. We need electricity to be productive. The cost of generating our own power is crippling. You know, and here again, I say sabotage the hands of Nigeria. They should just free us. Let's move forward. Let's move as a nation. You know, unemployment, poor education plus struggling economy means a lot of people are unemployed. Unemployed people are hungry and angry. You know, a high cost of living, food, transportation, medicine. Everything is 3 times, 4 times more expensive, but our salaries haven't increased. What do we do? You know, social justice. According to the Constitution, the Federal Republic of Nigeria is based on the principles of democracy and social justice.
There be one set of rules for the poor and another set of rules for the rich. You understand? Transparency. You know, the best way to kill corruption is increase transparency. Government finances and contract must be open and available to all. Who got the money to do what? By what kind of voters? Use the money. You see these things. It's a very good way to shame corruption. You know, cost of governance. Cost of government. Our governance is too expensive. I think it's expensive in this world. Federal, state, local level. Cars, housing, allowances. Come on, man. We have to make at least every other thing make sacrifice. Let our public officials also make some sacrifice. You know. Many public servants, some of them, they will. You know, that's cost of governance is too high. Patriotism. I stand with Nigeria. There is enough in Nigeria for all of us to chop belly full. Enough is enough. We must put Nigeria first. Keep greedy and send people away from leadership. All those people that will not make Nigeria work if they don't go their own personal way. We have to lead them. We have to come out. We have to be bold. You know. We have to be brave men and women in this country now. The time for playing politics, everything should be over. At least once politics time, but once politics time don't finish, make work start. Then let good people in government, let them stand up, let them speak up. You know, this the idea of just covering things, block this one here. Man, we need to just let's move. Nigeria is better than us. Let's just move, you know. So let's keep selfish interest from Nigeria. Let's work. Let's make this happen. This thing is not one man alone thing. It is all of us Nigerians. You understand? You know. So between now and Monday, February 6th, I ask you to share your videos or your thoughts or, you know, share whatever you feel on Facebook, Twitter, blogs, SMS to 090-2355-335. How are these issues affecting you? What are your daily struggles? How is it doing you? No matter what part of the world you are, I encourage you to share your story. And join your money to live or do a lot online. Use it to Nigeria. One voice Nigeria. Use all these hashtags to show you anything on this movement. Just use Nigeria. Those are the three hashtags. We will take all the reports and send our elected representatives as one voice of Nigerians across party, ethnic and religious lines. As the year people talk about issues, on Monday, 46th, meet me at the National Stadium at 8 a.m. and we will walk to the National Theatre. Just imagine, National Stadium, National Theatre. These two national icons, the genre is declining. You understand what I'm saying? So let's do that. Let's meet up and walk this walk as we state clearly and peacefully that I stand Nigeria. I must work for you. Nigeria must work for all of us, and all of us must work for Nigeria. This time, let's rise up. Let's do this thing. We will not just keep quiet again. You understand? Not be one man walk again. All of us walk. You understand? So, thank you. God bless you, and God bless Nigeria. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bless you, bless Nigeria.